everybody, but that's just kind of... but what I do know, or think, that is going to happen is a big, big war is coming. And it's going to be blamed on Israel, in a sense. We are going to, of course, side with Israel. And just like the script says, Barack Obama and his undying support for the Zionists and, you know, all this stuff... We'll go to war with this very bloody battle. It'll eventually cause a world conflict, probably a lot of cataclysms, whether real or not real, and famines and things like that. I've kind of talked about that before. But basically, the concept I'm trying to say is it's going to be very devastating. I think the more devastating that war, the better. Because at that point, we will all do exactly what happened in Nazi Germany. The conspiracy theories about the Jewish bankers and the Illuminati, except, you know, all that stuff will be brought out. This is why we're in war right now. This is why we're in such bad shape. It'll be the end of World War One all over again. Treaty of Versailles and all that stuff. I think that's where we're going. And I think conspiracy theories, especially Jewish ones, are going to be the order of the day. Very, very soon. And again, I don't think that this is like defending the Israel government by any means. That, I mean, even biblically, the governments of Israel would oftentimes go very, very far astray. But there were always the faithful remnant of Jewish people, and those people are continually persecuted, ridiculously persecuted by the same government that we think that they are. The New World Order, I think, wants to position themselves in Jerusalem as the capital for this New World Order. I think that's just the way that they're thinking. And because of that, they have completely infiltrated the Israeli government almost as much, if not much more, than they've infiltrated our government. We should sympathize and understand how it is that a government cannot represent its people at all. We should, of all people, understand that, because the rest of the world doesn't understand that. They see Americans as little George Bushes running around wanting to get in wars and everything, and we would just yell and scream, no, we don't think that, But for some reason, we just are completely blind to the idea that the same situation is happening in Israel. They are completely co-opted by this New World Order system that has infiltrated their government and not representing the true Jewish people who are getting killed and persecuted by the government that we think they are, just the same way they're doing here. So you may wonder, why is it that they're letting us learn all these conspiracy theories? Are we winning? No, we're losing. They are so happy to have us continually learn to wake up, as long as we wake up into their paradigm. Right now, we're all waking up into the New Age religion. They're creating little mini Masons and New Age people that are going to be just fit perfectly into the new system that I guarantee you is not going to look like what we are fighting. It's not going to be big bad George Bushes in the New World Order. It's going to be enlightenment, and, you know, everything's going to be great, and utopia and Atlantis, and everything's different, and we're going to just get rid of religions and start this whole thing over. It's not going to look like it is now, but they are preparing you. It's called the externalization of the hierarchy. They're so happy to have you wake up, as long as you're waking up to Michael Tsarian and Jordan Maxwell and Madame Blavatsky and 2012. You can wake up to that all day, and they're just waiting, biding their time until you're ready for the harvest. So how can you avoid it? Truth. You have to check things out. You have to realize that they're trying to indoctrinate you into their same Luciferian beliefs. And we are losing that battle for our minds. So wake up, realize that, and double check things, and hopefully we can still win this thing.